全球北半球现在处于高温的状态，但是高温的不是你想象的加州，也不是欧洲热浪，而是莫斯科、加拿大这些都非常靠近极地地区的，从来没有冷气，甚至这些国家有些地方从来没有电风扇，他们现在面临了将近摄氏37到40度的高温。
提到高温，你会联想到俄罗斯吗？通常此时俄罗斯的气温平均在21摄氏度左右，但近日北极圈以北的维科扬斯克竟然超过了摄氏47度。
Polar areas in the Arctic and in Russia are warming 3 times to 4 times faster than anywhere else in the world. So while this event is, you know, alarming in itself, to me, it's really the long-term trend. It's just warming so much quicker, and it's a sensitive region of ice and unique ecosystems that are going to be impacted by so much warming if we don't make a difference, and we still can.
根据俄罗斯水温气象与环境监测局的监测数据，首都莫斯科在21日站上了摄氏34.7度，上一次出现这样的高温是在1901年的6月，而莫斯科的最高温是在2010年的7月，当时曾出现摄氏38度。那一年俄罗斯西部多地受到大规模的热浪和野火侵袭，第二大城圣彼得堡也很热，一度到达摄氏34.7度，创下了1998年以来的最高纪录。专家表示，今年春天当地温度比往年平均高出8度，甚至有研究报告指出，去年西伯利亚的高温现象主要是由人为因素造成的。
The problem is we're getting these heat waves in Siberia, which are melting the sea ice earlier and earlier.You're getting all this incoming sunlight into the ocean that's storing heat in the dark ocean. So the ocean is just getting warmer and warmer. This heat in the ocean is preventing the sea ice to form. So not only is the ice melting earlier in summer, but it's also forming later in the fall and winter.
同样的，地球上的第二寒冷国家加拿大，在英属哥伦比亚地区6月27日达到了摄氏46.6度，创下1937年以来的最高纪录。
A heat dome is essentially a huge high pressure ridge. We get sinking air around a high pressure, and that basically acts like a cap, locking in and cooking the air below.
笼罩着北美西北太平洋沿岸的热盖上个周末开始发威，在美加上空形成了一个巨大的马蹄形阻塞高压，原本带来凉爽空气的喷射气流被高压阻挡，无法进入降温，让影响的区域被盖住闷烧。
This is unseasonably warm. We'll take it though. You know, sometimes we get snow in June, so we'll take the sun as we can get it.
近日来，美国的华盛顿州和奥勒冈州与酷暑有关的死亡事件已攀升至接近100例。相较于2017年至2019年，整个奥勒冈州通报12人被热死的情况严重许多，而因中暑就诊的人数也激增了数百人。而加拿大的不列颠哥伦比亚省至少报告了486例猝死事件。由于大多数的家庭没有冷气设备，热浪来袭难以招架。
It's been insane. Portable air conditioner fans all sold out everywhere you go. You can't find any. The people are selling it on the Facebook marketplace for $3 the price. So we're spending like $300.To sleep in a hotel tonight and have the baby and the dog in a room with air conditioning.
这不禁让人想起了2019年7月25日，那是巴黎最接近蒸笼地狱的一天，摄氏42.6度，不但是1947年7月28日以来巴黎史上第二次超过40度的门槛，同时也刷新了法国首都高温历史记录。与此同时，比利时、荷兰和德国等地也都出现了40度以上的高温。这场极端气候的震撼教育，造成了1600多人热死。而在美加地区，44度摄氏度，跳进水里可能会好受一点。
Yeah, it's hot. I mean, you just stand around and you're like, you can't breathe. It's so hot, at least for me. Definitely have to wear shoes.
Yeah, yeah, the pavement, even grass, really you're、hot. Just like, whoop, no thank you. Go back inside.
炙热的温度把电车缆线融化，高速公路的柏油路还因此干裂，必须暂时封闭。
Yeah, we measured the asphalt temperatures, 157 degrees on the streets, and there's been an explosion of homeless population here. So this is dangerous, dangerous.
近十年的夏季高温不算特别，但自6月27日以来一连五天，这是有史以来美国西北最热的天气记录。俄勒冈州华氏112度，西雅图华氏116度。
The main thing going on is this highly unusual weather pattern. But that being said, climate change is real. Our temperatures have warmed here, especially summer nighttime temperatures. And so that has just kind of raised the baseline and made this heat event that much more severe.
That is life-threatening heat. But for Portlanders, early in the summer, before we've had a chance to really get used to hot weather, that is really a public health threat.
如今，正当美国多地正为重新开放感到开心，高温带来的干旱和野火灾难正在以前所未有的速度前进。
This landscape screams problems to me. I mean, just look at the bathtub rings. To me, that is an enormous wake-up call.
位于内华达州与亚利桑那州交界的米德湖是美国最大的人造湖和水库，由著名的胡佛水坝拦截科罗拉多河之水而成。水库在大坝之后绵延180余公里，池水约350亿立方公尺。如今，米德湖处于近90年来的最低水位，只剩下37%的容量。干旱切断了水源，并且危及大坝的发电。科罗拉多河下游的亚利桑那、墨西哥和加州，原本茂密的农田深陷缺水困境之中。
We have a field that is not planted. It has no water.
数据监测，美国西部各州有54%的土地正在经历极端干旱，加州尤其严重，有85%的土地干涸。去年此时，一连串难以浇熄的野火，如同梦魇一般，让当地的居民心惊胆战。
I'm nervous. Last year being the worst fire season on record, this year is definitely shaping up to be even worse.
高温造成了森林野火在南加州洲际公路旁燃烧，消防员通宵灭火，疲于奔命。而年初才因冰风暴大停电的德州，日前也因高温供电吃紧，多个发电机组意外跳电停机。德州可靠电力委员会发出了节电警示，要求2600万用户减少用电，预防电网再度崩溃。面临这样的灾难，美国总统拜登与西部各州州长举行虚拟会议，讨论因应对策。
The extreme heat we're seeing in the West is not only a risk amplifier for wildfires, it's a threat in and of itself. People are hurting.
面对极端天气，不可否认的是，一些原本不习惯的事，现在也得面对了。纽约时报对高温做出的建议，除了努力控制温室气体排放，美国还需要采取艰难且代价高昂的措施来适应，就包括重新设计城市以承受酷暑，节约用水，和设计在极端天气下不会出现故障的电网。问题正一一在浮现。
谢谢你收看今天文倩的世界周报，文倩的世界财经周报。再一次祝福所有的人平安，一起感谢第一线医护跟防疫人员，谢谢你们。